An ambitious shift to renewable energy is underway in the Chatham Islands with hopes it will slash power costs. Currently, residents face the most expensive bills in the country, an average of $650 a month, and mostly rely on diesel. Kushla Norman visited the main island.
What made you come to the Chathams?
Oh, man.
50 years later, Glenis Day is still here, owning this cafe for nearly three decades. But running a business on an island reliant on diesel power is tough, especially with high fuel prices.
How big are your power bills here?
But outrageous. Huge, some
what
of them.
What are we talking?
For my business here, for 4 days of the week, $2,500 for a month.
But Glenis recently shifted to solar for her home.
$549 was my last power bill. Then I went solar, and from May onwards, it got less and less. October's power bill was $39.69.
From a distance, it looks like a plane wreck, but a closer look reveals the Chatham's failed experiment with wind.
It's a real shame because you can tell it's windy, and so there's no shortage of wind, and in fact, Chatham's would have been at the forefront of renewable energy.
The turbines, built in 2010, were funded by an Australian company, CBD Energy. They generated power for several years and bills dropped, but in the end it wasn't financially viable. The Chatham's Enterprise Trust commissioned the project and runs the island's electricity network.
The wind turbine up the road that we've seen abandoned, people are angry at seeing that site given that their power bills are now so astronomical. What's your response to that?
I can understand that because a lot of the community, of course, aren't aware that the electricity company had no commercial involvement in that other than a purchase agreement. So we were completely beholden upon that company.
But the Chathams is giving wind another go. $11 million was set aside in the budget for new turbines and batteries.
Approximately 70% of our diesel usage will be displaced. The energy costs will reduce by something like 50%.
We've had a windmill. It's lying on the ground. I don't believe another one should happen. That's my opinion, because I've seen what the sun does.
The first place to see the sun, now at a new dawn of renewable energy. Kushla Norman, One News.